Hello everyone, I am very much pleased and privileged to deliver a short video lecture on basically refrigerants. In the previous lecture videos, I have covered lectures on internal combustion engines followed by refrigeration. Earlier in 4 videos, I could deliver contents technically on internal combustion engines. In the last 3 videos, 2 to 3 videos, I have delivered lectures on introduction to refrigeration, followed by the fundamental terms associated with the refrigeration. Next, classification of refrigeration, mainly vapor compression refrigeration followed by vapor absorption refrigeration. Now it is the time to concentrate on purely refrigerants. We know about the principal components in a refrigeration system. Next, we could learn the fundamental terms associated. Later, we could know the theoretical description pertaining to vapor compression refrigeration followed by vapor absorption refrigeration. As you all know that in any form of refrigeration system, we find a thermofluid medium which has the potential to extract heat, which is very prominently called a refrigerant. So this lecture video emphasizes mainly on refrigerants. So we shall see what are all the information we require in this course basic of mechanical engineering or elements of mechanical engineering. We shall know what exactly the thermodynamic definition for a refrigerant. A refrigerant is a chemical substance or a thermofluid medium that is used in a refrigeration cycle to cool a space. Basically, it is a fluidal medium which has the potential to extract heat within the refrigeration system. That is why refrigerator, refrigerant. Next, before knowing the properties of a good refrigerator or good refrigerant, we shall have a brief historical idea relating to refrigerant. Actually speaking, an American mechanical engineer by name Sir Thomas Midgley. He could clearly distinguish a refrigerant, the desirable properties of good refrigerant. Normally speaking, we find primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. We should not go to the depth of refrigerants. Why? Because in this course, we should be aware of the content to the surface level. So honestly, we shall not scratch too much about this, but we shall have a fundamental and clear idea regarding refrigerants. As just said, it's a thermofluid medium wherein it has the potential to extract heat within the refrigeration system. We have many refrigerants. Commonly used are ammonia, Freon 12, Freon 22, then sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide, water, methyl chloride, and many more. Presently, researchers have been fascinated in using a variety of refrigerants. But before you use a variety of refrigerants or refrigerants in exorbitance or plethora, we shall be aware of the desirable properties of a good refrigerant. So, good refrigerator, good refrigerant. This slide will give you the clear idea regarding that. See, in the block you can see the properties of a good refrigerant. In that we have 4 classification. The first is the thermodynamic properties, Next physical, third one safe working properties, the last miscellaneous properties. So thermodynamic, physical, chemical, we have many properties, desirable requisites for a good refrigerant. But as said, we shall not go to the depth of it. We will just see to the information in the surface level. When we peep to thermodynamic properties, normally the first one shall be latent heat of vaporization. You all know that in a refrigerator, evaporator is used. Evaporator has the potential to undergo evaporation, wherein the refrigerant should have high latent heat of vaporization. Since heat is continuously extracted in a evaporator, we expect any refrigerant to have high latent heat of vaporization. Next, the property shall be low boiling point, low freezing point. Then we should concentrate on evaporator and condenser pressure. So these are all the desirable thermodynamic properties what we normally take. Next comes the physical properties. Physical properties basically emphasize on specific volume. Next, viscosity. Then specific heat capacity. No doubt, this can also be called thermophysical properties. So thermophysical properties include thermal conductivity, coefficient of expansion, thermal diffusivity, like that. But preferably when we are speaking in the context of refrigerants, specific volume, specific heat capacity, viscosity, they are all very important. Next, safe working properties, toxicity. So it should be definitely non-toxic. Then flammability. If it is highly flammable, it is really problematic. So flammability aspect. Then corrosiveness. It should be non-corrosive, odor-free, then non-toxic. So these are all the safe working properties what we need to see upon. Next comes chemical stability. Whichever refrigerant we prefer, it should not have any sort of chemical reaction. It should not react with any lubricating oil. If that happens, definitely there shall be an explosion hazard. Very analogous in the case of internal combustion engine. Last comes the miscellaneous or the additional properties, very important coefficient of performance. Usually, coefficient of performance of any refrigerator is very important. Like that, it should be odor-free, then leakage. When I did the comparative study between VCR and VAR, vapor compression refrigeration and vapor absorption refrigeration, unquestionably, because of the incorporation of compressor, loud noise, vibration shall be induced in vapor compression refrigerator. In addition to that, there should be leakage of refrigerant. So it should be leak free. Leakage should not be a major problem. Then action with lubricating oil. Just now I mentioned that. So generally speaking, what are all the desirable properties of a good refrigerant for a good refrigerator? High latent heat of vaporization, low magnitude of boiling and freezing point, then the magnitude of condenser and evaporator pressure. You all know that condenser pressure dominates evaporator pressure. Next comes specific volume, specific heat capacity, next viscosity. Then later when we take up safe working properties, non-toxic, then flammability, yes, it is very important, non-corrosive, odor-free, then there should not be any sort of chemical reaction with lubricating oil. So these are all the properties what we need to emphasize. If we know this, then the selection of refrigerant shall be easy. As just said before, listing out the properties of a good refrigerant, what are all the various refrigerants we normally consider. Usually these refrigerants invariably possess these properties. When we take a vapor compression refrigeration system, we normally use Freon 12. When we take a vapor absorption refrigeration, it shall be Freon 22. When we take up the other forms of refrigeration, see, even in vapor absorption, Freon 22 and even ammonia shall be considered. Very commonly ammonia, but Freon 12 we use in air conditioning systems. So ammonia, Freon 12, Freon 22, presently the researchers are exploring on a variety of refrigerants. A very common one is R134a. When we start listing out the names of refrigerants, it may be endless nowadays. A few researchers are exploring on the variety of refrigerants on a particular refrigeration system. So nowadays we have nano refrigerants. So knowing about refrigerants, it is absolutely voluminous. It is just immeasurable. In one of my video lectures I said, some of the topics cannot be measured. Few oceans can be measured, but a few topics in any of the course shall be incalculable or immeasurable. One such reference is refrigeration. Then, when we come to types of refrigerants, we have ammonia, the oldest and widely used. Then the boiling point temperature is -33.3°C. Then soluble in water, produce high refrigeration effect, costless, then does not harm ozone layer. That is very important. So whichever refrigerant we use, that should not pose any peril or hazard to environment. So highly toxic, explosive, moderately flammable, irritating and corrosive. So this will really hamper. Seeing to the requirement, we have to take up large scale applications like ICE, manufacturing plants, packing plants, cold storage and many more. So this is regarding ammonia. Next we take up sulfur dioxide, boiling point -10°C. Non-flammable, non-corrosive, absorbs a lot of heat in evaporation. Low refrigeration effect, suffocating, irritating. So these two may definitely hamper. If there is the problem of suffocation, we cannot commonly prefer that. Used in olden days, but now it is almost obsolete. As said in the previous lecture video, very commonly are ammonia and Freon 12. Next shall take up carbon dioxide, boiling point -77.6°C. Non-flammable, non-toxic, inexpensive and odorless. Then 1.53 times heavier than air and hence requires high operating pressure, thereby lowering the efficiency of refrigeration. Then due to low magnitude of specific volume, plant size can be made compact. Then large ships, then theater air conditioning system utilizes carbon dioxide. So this is also not very commonly used. Next comes Freon, one of the favorites for the present day researchers. Freon 12 and 22, highly efficient and overcome the disadvantages of all above types of refrigerants. However, these refrigerants were discovered to deplete the ozone layer. So along with that, we have Freon 12. So boiling point -29.8°C, non-flammable, non-explosive, non-corrosive and odorless. The next comes Freon 22, boiling point -40.8°C, high pressure refrigerant. It shall be employed for high capacity plants like packet air conditioning units, low and medium temperature refrigeration. So these are all the very commonly used refrigerants in a variety of refrigeration system. Then types of refrigerants. Earlier I could tell about primary and secondary refrigerants. So Thomas Midgley in 1928 could take the lead in classifying refrigerants. So modern refrigerants, hydrofluorocarbon, no chlorine atoms, thus have no ozone depleting potential, possess favorable thermodynamic, health and safety properties, R134a is non-corrosive, non-toxic and non-flammable. Boiling point temperature is minus 15 degrees centigrade. Hydrofluorocarbon compounds include R407C, R410A, etc. So, when we come to domestic refrigeration, compressor is a very commonly used component which is employed in a reciprocating type and is hermetically sealed, which means the compressor and electric motor are a single unit enclosed in a container. So we will be aware of the commercial or industrial refrigeration system but unaware of domestic refrigeration. Then comes condenser and finally the expansion device. So as said, this is a short lecture video on refrigerants. Before taking up the last video that shall be exclusively covered on air conditioning, we shall know what exactly is a refrigerant, what are all the forms of refrigerants we take up, classification of refrigerants, and finally the desirable properties of good refrigerants. This is what I was willing to cover in this lecture video. So in the next lecture video, we shall be covering on air conditioning. That shall be the last lecture video in this module. Thank you all. Thank you.